for Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami for different instances, for in different places. But even the mood with which he is actually taking up the mission, also we can see it's a clear reflection of the mood of Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. So, just to give a quick recap, first two chapters, they discuss about the synopsis of Madhya Leela and Anti Leela. Third to sixth chapter discusses about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to Shantipur. So this is the summary of Madhya Leela. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to Shantipur, from there going to Puri, and then he, him preaching to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya getting transformed to a Vaishnav. Seventh to tenth chapter discusses about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's tour to South India, from Bengal all the way to Cape Comorin or Kanyakumari, going all the way to Narmada in Western India, and then retracing back the exact same path. 11 to 15, it discusses about after Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu finishes his tour, when he comes back to Puri, devotees were in separation of the Lord, especially the devotees from Bengal. So everyone comes there. 11 to 15 captures the pastimes during the entire Ratayatra time. Usually devotees come to Puri from Mayapur and they would stay there for 4 months. So that beautiful pastimes, they are narrated in these five chapters. 16 to 18 is it narrates about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's final successful attempt. Every time he tries to go, devotees always stop him. So finally he goes there with Balabhadra Bhattacharya to Vrindavan. And then along the way he also instructs few personalities, and that appears in the last six chapters of Madhya Leela, which is chapter 19 to 25, which is teachings of Lord Chaitanya. Primarily, it touches on teachings to Rupa Goswami, which Srila Rupa Goswami later on writes as Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu instructs Srila Rupa Goswami for 10 days in Prayag. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he comes to Varanasi, there he instructs, or Kasi, he instructs Srila Sanatana Goswami for 2 months. And on devotional service, avatar, everything, avatar tattva, everything. And then this also describes about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's discussion with Prakashananda Saraswati and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu converting all the Mayavadis, Mayavadi sannyasis, into Gaudiya Vaishnavism. So that's Madhya Leela. So yesterday we went through summary till this much, and then we went through some of the verses in chapter 1. In fact, till end of the synopsis of Madhya Leela, as I said, of chapter 1 and 2 of Madhya Leela. Chapter 1, almost 2/3 of it discusses about the synopsis of entire Madhya Leela. So all of this is there in just the 2/3 of the first chapter itself. The last 1/3 of the first chapter and the entire second chapter, it discusses on Anti Leela. That's what I'm planning to cover today. Let's see how much we can do. So the end of chapter 1, it gives a quick summary of the different pastimes of the Supreme Lord that's narrated in Anti Leela. So I'll read verse by verse. Let's see how far we can go. If we can't finish it, then we'll come back tomorrow and finish this one before we move to chapter 2. So this is Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Leela, chapter 1, verse 246. So Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Leela, chapter 1, text 246. The Lord travelled all over India for 6 years. He was sometimes here and sometimes there, performing his transcendental pastimes, and sometimes he remained at Jagannath Puri. While at Jagannath Puri, the Lord passed his time in great joy by performing Sankirtana and visiting the temple of Jagannatha in great ecstasy. 248. Thus I have given a synopsis of the Madhya Leela, the middle pastimes of the Lord. Now, O devotees, kindly hear the synopsis of the final pastimes of the Lord, known as the Anti Leela. When the Lord returned to Jagannath Puri from Vrindavana, he remained there and did not go anywhere else for 18 years. During these 18 years, all the devotees of Bengal used to visit him at Jagannath Puri every year. They would remain there for 4 continuous months and enjoy the company of the Lord. At Jagannath Puri, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu performed chanting and dancing unceasingly. So you'll find the detailed description of all of that in Antyalila. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu performing Sankirtana pastimes with his devotees. So this is verse 251. Thus he enjoyed the pastime of Sankirtana. He manifested his causeless mercy, pure love of God to everyone, including the lowest men. 252. Residing with the Lord at Jagannath Puri where Pandita Gosani. So if you see Pandita Gosani, it's Gadadhar Pandit. And other devotees such as Vakreshwar Pandit, the great dancer, Damodar Pandit. There is one pastime that will come shortly about Damodar Pandit, Shankara and Haridas Thakur. 253. Jagadananda Pandit, Bhagavan, Govinda, Kashishwara, Paramananda Puri, and Swarup Damodar were other devotees who also lived with the Lord. 254. Srila Ramananda Roy and other devotees who were residents of Jagannath Puri also remained permanently with the Lord. Prabhupada says the devotees ask for only one benediction. The devotees' ardent desire is only one, which is to always be in the company of the Lord. So Prabhupada says that is the greatest benediction which the devotees always aspire for. Not in a sense gratificatory mode, but the devotees always want to be at the beck and call of the Lord. Anything which the Lord wants, we want to serve. So let us also aspire to be in the company of Shishi Radha Gopinath, Sri Jagannath Baladeshu Bhadra Maharani, Shishi Gaur Nithai eternally. And let that be our constant meditation. There is nothing more that needs to be attained. There is nothing more that need to be desired. We have everything. We just need to maintain ourselves by sharing this message with everyone. At Jagannath Puri, Srila Rupa Goswami, other devotees, this is 255, 256, Madhya Leela chapter 1. Other devotees of the Lord, headed by Sri Advaita Acharya, Nityananda Prabhu, Mukunda, Srivasa, Vidyanidhi, Vasudeva and Murari, used to visit Jagannath Puri and remain with the Lord for 4 continuous months. So all these great devotees, Advaita Acharya, Nityananda Prabhu, Mukunda is Mukunda Datta, Srivas Thakur, Vidyanidhi, Pundarik Vidyanidhi is also there, Vasudeva and Murari used to visit Jagannath Puri and remain with the Lord for 4 continuous months. The Lord enjoyed various pastimes in their company. 257. At Jagannath Puri, Haridas Thakura passed away. Now he'll start to list one pastime after the other. So the next series of verses, you will see him compressing all the Antilila pastime. At Jagannath Puri, Haridas Thakura passed away. The incident was very wonderful because the Lord himself performed the festival of Thakura Haridasa's departure. Many instances you will see like that. Govinda Ghosh pastime. How Gopinath till date he is doing start ceremony for his dad. So you will see same pastime that's been performed by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also when he goes to Gaya for the Pindadan on behalf of his father Jagannath Mishra. So same Supreme Lord Ramachandra, he did it for Jatayu. Shabari. So you'll come across all those instances how time and again Supreme Lord is ready to give himself to the devotees in whatever capacity that they want him to reciprocate with. By every means he is giving himself. So here also Haridas Thakur, it's a very heartrending portion, but you will see how even in that heartrending section you will find how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he still exhibits his ecstasy, teaching us that the departure of a Vaishnava or a Vaishnavi is a bittersweet experience. On one hand, we are very happy that they have eternally joined, or they have joined the eternal pastime, Nityalila, of Sri Radha Gopinath. But on the other hand, the pain is there that we will be bereft with their Vapu Sangha from that point onwards. 258. At Jagannath Puri, Srila Rupa Goswami met the Lord again, and the Lord invested his heart with all transcendental power. So even though he sends Rupa Goswami first to Vrindavan as well as Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami come back again to Puri to meet the Lord. So you will see like that few instances. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu meets these devotees a few times. Raghunath Das Goswami, for example, Raghunath Bhatta. First in Varanasi, then in Puri, then only he goes to Vrindavan. Gopala Bhatta Goswami associates with the Lord in Vrindavan. Srirangam, and then goes back. So like that, you will see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu does the induction for all his disciples this way. At different places, he'll give them instructions very personally. He would tell them to go to Vrindavan, and then he'll invite them also. Come and spend some time here with the other devotees like that. So here Rupa Goswami, after he went to Vrindavan on the order of the Supreme Lord, he comes to Puri again to associate with the Lord. He invested his heart with all transcendental power. There is a beautiful section. We'll read that. How Srila Rupa Goswami, one day during Ratayatra time, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu chants and dances, and he starts to recite a verse of Srimati Radharani. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says, almost nobody could understand. This is exactly his words. All the devotees are stunned. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, he's feeling separation, and they are saying, but my Lord is there, Jagannath is there. How can there be separation like that? But Srila Rupa Goswami, he also dances, he hears this, Swarup Damodar also hears this, Ramananda Roy also hears this. Very confidential devotees could understand. Rupa Goswami then goes back to Siddha Bakula, where Haridas Thakur is there. It's mentioned, Srila Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami and Haridas Thakur, they never went into the Jagannath temple to take darshan of the Lord, because they didn't want to disturb the social order. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself would go. But it's mentioned, Krishna S. Kaviraj Goswami mentions that whenever Chaitanya Mahaprabhu goes, sometimes all three of them will be there. Sometimes some would go and take bath, so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would see two only. Sometimes when he goes, only one of them will be there. Very, it's like four friends meeting. Yeah, when there, where were you? You know, they ask. So in this particular instance, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu goes, Haridas Thakur is there, but Rupa Goswami is not there. But Rupa Goswami, after hearing this verse, he writes, because Rupa Goswami could understand that not many can understand this. So that's how he writes Laghu Bhagavatamrita. And he hears Brihat Bhagavatam. Obviously there is Srimad Bhagavatam, which is so complicated. So Sanatana Goswami, he wrote Brihat Bhagavatamrita, thinking Kali Yuga Vasis, they can't really understand fully Srimad Bhagavatam. It's also voluminous. But then when Rupa Goswami read that, he really liked it. But feeling very compassionate upon all of us, he thought, you know, Kali Yuga Vasi is hopeless even for Brihat Bhagavatamrita. So he writes a Laghu Bhagavatamrita, very small, but condensed to form of all avatar tattva, and all the pastimes are there. Such a beautiful book. So Srila Rupa Goswami, as our parampara acharya, we are all called Rupanugas, Prabhupada says. So as a parampara acharya, he understands the verse. To give the purport to the verse of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he writes another verse. Another long verse. And he writes it in a palm leaf, leaves it, and he goes to the ocean to take bath. So meanwhile, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes there, he looks around, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's height, he just pulls it out. He just puts it on the roof. He pulls it out and he reads. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was feeling so blissed. Meanwhile, as he was reading, Rupa Goswami comes and he offers prostrated obeisances to the Supreme Lord. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu feels so happy. It's mentioned in this instance. He pulls Rupa Goswami, makes him seated on his lap, and he asks him, very like how two intimate friends would speak. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu puts his shoulder on him and makes him sit on his lap. And he says, so how did you understand my heart? And then Rupa Goswami says, my Lord, I don't know anything. And whatever you give me, I can repeat. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu tells to Swarup Damodar, yes, he is fit to, I have already noted him, he is very fit to propagate this mercy of Krishna and explain about bhakti to everyone. So I have given him special potency like that. Swarup Damodar also says that, my Lord, he can explain only after you give the mercy. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself asks Swarup Damodar, what do you think? How did Rupa Goswami understood my heart? Then Swarup Damodar also repeats what Rupa Goswami says. My Lord, I know only one thing. No, you are Swarat, but everyone is dependent on you. Unless you give the potency to someone, nobody can glorify you. So it's a very sweet pastime. So in Jagannath Puri, Srila Rupa Goswami met the Lord again, and the Lord invested his heart with all transcendental power. 259 Madhyalila chapter 1 text 259 after this the Lord punished junior Haridas we have beautiful artwork and Damodar Pandit gave some warning to the Lord this is a very sweet pastime so first half is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teaching how somebody in sannyas order how strict they should be when it comes to associating with the opposite sex so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu he demonstrates that through junior Haridas or Chota Haridas the other pastime is about Damodar Pandit how he gave some warning to the Lord so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in one instance what happens there used to be one very young devotee of the supreme lord a young boy who is born of a brahmana father and brahmana mother but his father passed away so the boy every day he used to come he accepts Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as his life and soul so every day he used to come now Damodar Pandit would forbid the boy from meeting Chaitanya Mahaprabhu somehow he'll create some obstacle so the boy cannot meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu so it goes on the boy also somehow would sneak and he would take darshan associate with the Lord and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also would give care and attention because he know this boy lost his father young and he is so attached to his lotus feet but Damodar Pandit one day comes and he tells to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that this boy is very young the father has passed away and your intention is good but this boy has his mother is still there who is a widow who is a beautiful looking brahmani and you are a very handsome looking young man for somebody who is envious of you if they actually see you associating with this boy they will speak bad about you and I can't tolerate this so he tells to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu of course my lord you are independent so then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brings him Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami he explains that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu smiles first of all and then he comes to Damodar Pandit and he tells him that you are of all my associates you are the one who is neutral you didn't even get scared to chastise me he tells how can I find someone who is more confidential than you who is more confidential well wisher than you I was looking for someone to go and take care of I is Sachi Mata so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu tells it will be such a big favor for me if you can go and serve my mother and by the way when you go and meet her convey to her this confidential message and Prabhupada there he writes you will see Prabhupada quoting also in few lectures on Chaitanya Charitamrita Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appears in four places two are related to chanting and dancing two are related to prasad two places where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always appears is whenever there is kirtan goes on in Sriva Sangam Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will personally appear even though he may be in Puri whenever there is kirtan in Sriva Sangam when Srivas Thakur is leading he'll come there likewise whichever part of the world whenever Nityananda Prabhu leads chanting and dancing immediately Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will appear there so this is two places where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will appear two other places where he will appear one is related to this pastime he tells to Damodar Pandit you please go and tell Sachi Mata that I am coming personally to her altar and honoring the prasad and he tell Chaitanya Mahaprabhu tells also even if she doesn't believe you tell her last week she cooked a condensed milk preparation and when she offered it I came right in front of her and I took and she was sitting looking at me mesmerized but somehow she understood she is just dreaming and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says I could hear her saying that you know I'm just dreaming of Nimai like that even though Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is sitting and eating in front and then she goes she sees the bhoga still in the pot she serves again thinking I'm just thinking something else hallucinating then she comes and leaves the bhoga again Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says I sat down and I took the anna also the rice also go and tell her that and tell her every single time she offers bhoga I will come and personally take because I can't taste her bhakti enough so he gives this confidential service to Damodar Pandit and he goes fourth place where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always appears is whenever Raghava Pandit cooks and offers bhoga so beautiful pastimes the details of that we'll see in Antilila 260 thereafter Sanatana Goswami met the Lord again and the Lord tested him in scorching heat during the month of Jyeshta so there is a beautiful series of verses that explains. There are a lot of details there. We don't have much time. When we come there to Antilila, we can discuss that. Text 261, being pleased, the Lord sent Sanatana Goswami back to Vrindavana. After that, he was fed wonderfully by the hands of Sri Advaita Acharya. 262, after sending Sanatana Goswami back to Vrindavana, the Lord privately consulted with Sri Nityananda Prabhu. He then sent him to Bengal to preach love of Godhead. If you read that section, Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, every time Nityananda Prabhu would come, they both would have a very private conversation under a tree. Nobody would go near. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says, only those two lords would know what they discussed. They may be discussing preaching report. How is it going on in Puri, rest of India? So, constantly making plans. One of Supreme Lord's name is Hari Medha Sah. Prabhupada says, Hari Medha Sah also it's given. One who is constantly, Prabhupada says, one who is constantly thinking how to reclaim back all the conditioned souls. So this is also one name of the Supreme Lord, Hari Medha Sah. Prabhupada says, he always constantly, and same instruction Prabhupada also gives to all of us, all his Diksha, Siksha disciples, everyone. Prabhupada says, you constantly tax your brains to see and figure out how you can keep on multiplying this book distribution. And every year Prabhupada would say, double it. So I want all the leaders, all the members of Hare Krishna movement to constantly tax their brains to spread this Krishna consciousness movement, to distribute these books. Prabhupada says like that. After sending Sanatana Goswami, the Lord privately consulted with Sri Nityananda Prabhu. He then sent him to Bengal to preach love of Godhead. 263. Soon afterward, Vallabha Bhatta met the Lord at Jagannath Puri, and the Lord explained to him the import of the holy name of Krishna. We discussed about this in Navadvip Mandal Parikram also briefly. Vallabhacharya. 264. After explaining the transcendental qualities of Ramananda Roy, the Lord sent Pradyumna Mishra to his residence, and Pradyumna Mishra learned Krishna Katha from him. So when Pradyumna Mishra approaches Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, oh, I'm not qualified for Krishna Katha. There is a purest devotee amongst all of us, Ramananda Roy. You please go and hear from him. And he sends Ramananda Roy, Pradyumna Mishra there. 265. After this, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saved Gopinath Patanayaka, the younger brother of Ramananda Roy, from being condemned to death by the king. So there is a beautiful pastime there. How Gopinath Patanayaka, he accrues debt, he couldn't pay it back, and then he was condemned to death. But then at the time of death, Gopinath Patanayaka, he thinks, okay, anyway I'm going to die, let me at least take shelter of the Lord. So he takes, just does manasa seva, but that act of manasa seva is enough to bring a change of heart in the prince. And the prince comes and he relieves him of that, and the king also relieves him of the punishment and doubles his salary. You know, from that point, if you see, you'll see that's what happens. Katanchana smritayasmin dushkaram shukaram bhavet vishmrite viparitam sya sri chaitanyam namamitam. Even the most difficult things become very easy if one somehow or other remembers the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And the most, even the most easy things become very difficult if one forgets to do so. So we have to always remember the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, especially in this day and age. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki jai. 266, Ramachandra Puri criticized Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's eating. Therefore, the Lord reduced his eating to a minimum. So there is one pastime where Ramachandra Puri, he comes and he dares criticize the Lord in a very envious mode, you will see. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu reduces the eating. And then when he sees all the devotees are getting very upset because they want the Lord to eat more, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu increases it a bit more. So that's what it's given it. He increases his portion to half as much as usual. However, when all the Vaishnavas became very sorry, the Lord increased his portion to half as much as usual. 267, there are 14 planetary systems within the universe, and all the living entities reside in those planetary systems. Dressing like human beings on pilgrimage, they all used to come to Jagannath Puri to visit Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Very fortunate demigods. They will live and they'll live to see all the different incarnations and they'll come and take advantage. So here they are coming in disguise as human beings and they will visit Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu this way. 269, one day all the devotees headed by Srivas Thakura were chanting the transcendental qualities of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is a very funny pastime. Not liking the chanting of his transcendental qualities, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu chastised them as if he were angry. What kind of chanting is this? He asked. Are you leaving aside the chanting of the holy name of the Lord? So this is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is chastising Srivas Thakura and everyone. Thus, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu chastised all the devotees, telling them not to show impudence and spoil the entire world by becoming independent. And Prabhupada in this purport he writes, as rightly predicted by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that's what happened after the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Panchatattva, everyone they disappeared. I'll read the purport. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu warned all his followers not to become independent or impudent. In other words, we should strictly follow what is given in the Shastra. Prabhupada once, when he was actually going to his room, he hears a devotee is chanting Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, like that. Then Prabhupada was very upset and he calls the devotees who is leading and he says, what is this Hari Bol, Hari Bol? I don't know where this Hari Bol will take you. I will chant Hare Krishna and I'll go to Goloka, like that. So we have to be very, very careful that we don't add or subtract anything. Prabhupada didn't like when devotees were chanting Bhaja Sri Krishna, Bhaja Hare Krishna. Prabhupada says, what is this Bhaja? Why do you add? So Prabhupada didn't like just chanting Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Prabhupada didn't like adding anything like Bhaja. Prabhupada says Hare Krishna Mahamantra itself is complete. We don't need to add or subtract anything to that and we don't need to concoct anything. So we have to be careful. So any name, authorized name that's given in the scriptures, we chant. Gauranga, it's given as four syllable mantra, so we chant. It's there in everywhere. It's there in Chaitanya Charitamrita, it's there in Chaitanya Bhagavata, Chaitanya Mangala, everywhere it's there. So authorized names like that, where devotees chanted, we can chant, but nothing concocting. And there are pastimes there where Prabhupada said, don't waste time, just chant Hare Krishna. Don't chant Hari Bol, like that. So here also Prabhupada is warning. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu warned all his followers not to become independent or impudent. Unfortunately, after the disappearance of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, many appasampradayas invented many ways not approved by the acharyas. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has described them as Aula Baula, Kartabaja, Neda, Daravesha, Shani Sahajya, Shakibeki, Smartha, Jata Goshani, Ativadi, Chudadari and Gauranga Nahari. Actually, there is a purport to each one of them. When we come to that, we'll touch on that. What each one of them do, Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains. Okay, so text 272. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was apparently in an angry mood and chastising his devotees, many thousands of people outside loudly cried in a tumultuous voice, all glories to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Jai Krishna Chaitanya, Jai Krishna Chaitanya. That's what the verse goes. Jai Krishna Chaitanya Bali Kare Kolahale. Kolahale is very jubilantly they were chanting. So 273, all the people began to call very loudly, all glories to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is the son of Maharaj Nanda. Now you have appeared in order to deliver the whole world. Oh Lord, we are very unhappy. This is verse 274. Oh Lord, we are very unhappy. We have come a long distance to see you. Please be merciful and show us your favor. When the Lord heard the humble petition made by the people, his heart softened. Premavashya, one who is controlled, ajita jitopi hasita istri lokyam, one whose heart is controlled by the love, ardent love of his devotees. One, even though who is called as ajita, becomes jita. One, ajita is unconquerable, becomes jita or conquerable by the love of his devotees. So when the Lord heard the humble petition made by the people, his heart softened. Being very merciful, he immediately came out and gave audience to all of them. Raising his arms, the Lord asked everyone to chant loudly the vibration of the holy name of Lord Hari. There immediately arose a great stir and the vibration of Hari filled all directions. You can imagine, you know, tens or hundreds of thousands of people saying, Hari, Hari. So the vibration of Hari filled all directions. 277, seeing the Lord, everyone became joyful out of love. Everyone accepted the Lord as the Supreme, and thus they offered their prayers. While the people were offering their prayers unto the Lord, Srivastakura sarcastically said to the Lord, "At home you want to be covered. Why have you exposed yourself outside?" Which means Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, whenever anyone glorifies as Supreme Lord, he would close his eyes and he will say, "Vishnu, Vishnu," and he will run away. But here Srivastakura is saying, this is what you did inside. But look at you now. You are now forced to accept your supreme position. What are you going to do now? Like that, he is teasing the Lord very playfully. Srivastakura continued, "Who has taught these people? What are they saying?" He is now playing very innocent. "Now you can cover their mouths with your own hand." He said, like, how many people's mouth are you going to cover? You know, some, everyone knows your position now. 280. "It is as if the sun, after rising, wanted to hide itself. We cannot understand such characteristics in your behavior." The Lord replied, "My dear Srinivasa, please stop joking. You have all combined together to humiliate me in this way." This is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying. Thus speaking, the Lord entered his room after glancing auspiciously upon the people out of charity. We have to understand about the glance. Glance is not a casual look. Glance is imbued with love. Auspiciously it's given, imbued with love. But you know, the pastime where it's given, you know, Krishna having lunch with all his friends, everyone was thinking that Krishna is looking at me. Likewise, when Krishna and Balaram running, all the gopas are running, everyone had the opportunity to touch, you know, that famous artwork, beautiful artwork, Krishna and Balaram, you know, in gopa form, they are running with the calf. And all of them coming, pastime as it goes, that everyone came and touched him. The Lord allowed everyone to come and touch him. So same way here, when Supreme Lord is just looking like this, everyone felt the Supreme Lord is just looking at them. And the Supreme Lord was looking at each one of them auspiciously. And they were satisfied just with that look. So when we come to the temple, when we come in front of Radha Gopinath also, we have the same feeling. Whenever you come, everyone feel, I'm special. I'm special. So that's not wonderful. Krishna managed like this 16,108 queens. Everyone was feeling, I'm special. And everyone is special to the Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord alone can maintain like that. We cannot do. So here, Supreme Lord, the Lord, thus speaking, the Lord entered his room after glancing auspiciously upon the people out of charity. So he's giving his glance, love-filled, love-imbued glance as charity. In this way, the desires of the people were completely fulfilled. 283. At that time, Raghunath Dasa approached Sri Nityananda Prabhu and, according to his order, prepared a feast and distributed prasadam composed of chipped rice and curd. Chudadahi festival. So that narration is also given. Later, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami left home and took shelter of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at Jagannath Puri. At that time, the Lord received him and placed him under the care of Swarup Damodara for spiritual enlightenment. So that's when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives this instruction, 8 instructions to Raghunath Das Goswami. Grame kata na shunibe, grame varta na kahibe, balona khaibayar, balona paribe, amani manadahan Krishna nama sadalabe, vraja radha Krishna seva manase karibe. So all these 8, never hear prajalpa, talk prajalpa, don't eat very palatable, rich, opulent food, don't dress very flamboyantly, amani manadahan, never expect any respect from others, but be ready to offer all respect to others. Chant Hare Krishna, Krishna nama sadalabe, always chant Hare Krishna, vraja radha Krishna seva manase karibe. Then in that mood, after satisfying all these qualities and chanting Hare Krishna, now may you be in a position to meditate on the Nitya Seva of Sri Sri Radha Gopinath. So that's the instructions he gives, and it's very relevant for all of us also as devotees of Radha Gopinath. Srila Raghunath Das Goswami is the Prayojan Acharya. Later, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stopped Brahmananda Bharati's habit of wearing deer skin. The Lord thus enjoyed his pastimes continuously for 6 years, experiencing varieties of transcendental bliss. I have thus given a synopsis of Madhya Leela. Now, after touching on all the pastimes of Antya Leela, he is now going back to where he left off, to back to the two-third position. So he is concluding this chapter because Antya Leela synopsis is not over yet. He is going to continue in the next chapter. So here he is saying, I have thus given a synopsis of Madhya Leela. Now please hear the pastimes of the Lord performed during the last 12 years. So that he is going to narrate. So if you see, actual Madhya Leela is 6 years. So if you take the remaining 24, that 24 also he is dividing it into 3 parts. First 6 years when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu goes to South Indian tour everywhere, he goes to Vrindavana. That's the actual Madhya Leela which we see in this. But in Antya, so that leaves you with 18 years. Of that remaining 18 years, he is taking the first 6 years out. That's when you actually see all these pastimes, starting from junior Haridas Thakur all the way to Brahmananda Bharati. That happened in the first 6 years of the last 18 years. Okay, now he is coming to the final remaining 12 years. So that he will explain in the second chapter. Now in second chapter, I'll just read the introduction to that, and then I'll go to a section that describes about the qualities of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and the Phalastuti, the benefit which we get by reading Chaitanya Charitamrita, even if we don't understand. And Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami specifically emphasizes that. Even if you don't understand, what benefit we get. So we'll read that section. So this is chapter 2, the ecstatic manifestations of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In this chapter, the author describes, this is Prabhupada writing, the summary of chapter 2. In this chapter, the Lord describes the pastimes the Lord performed during the last 12 years of his life. Thus, he has also described some of the pastimes of the Antya Leela. Why he has done so is very difficult for an ordinary person to understand. The author expects that reading the pastimes of the Lord will gradually help a person awaken his dormant love for Krishna. Actually, now Prabhupada is revealing, actually this Chaitanya Charitamrita was compiled by the author during very old age. Fearing he might not be able to finish the book, he has included a synopsis of Antya Leela here in the second chapter. Srila Kaviraj Goswami has confirmed that the opinion of Swarup Damodara is authoritative in the matter of devotional service. Swarup Damodara is Lalita Sakhi. Over and above, these are the notes of Swarup Damodara memorized by Raghunath Das Goswami. So Raghunath Das Goswami also took a lot of association from Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, more than 18 years in Puri. And he was put, there were three Raghunatha. You will see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself mentions that there is Raghunath Bhatta, there is Raghunath Vaidya, and there is Raghunath Dasa. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, from now on may you be called as Swarupera Raghunatha, which means Raghunatha, Swarup Damodar's Raghunath. That Raghunath who belongs to Swarup Damodar, like that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu puts him under the care of Swarup Damodar. So Raghunath Das Goswami, he personally witnessed. Not only that, after witnessing, he also refers to the notes of Swarup Damodar. Swarup Damodar, after, as a secretary, after writing all the pastimes, he hands it over to Raghunath Das Goswami. Then after Swarup Damodar's disappearance, Raghunath Das Goswami then goes to Vrindavan to climb, to look at, to take darshan of all Goswamis and to climb on top of Govardhana Hill and commit suicide. That's the plan. But then, that's when he was requested by Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami to sit and narrate about the pastimes. And then when that pastimes were narrated, it's mentioned here that he himself memorized all the notes of Swarup Damodar. He then comes and narrates it. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami memorizes and then he writes. Same parampara as we see in Srimad Bhagavatam being written. So here, fearing he might not be able to finish the book, he has included a synopsis of the Antya Leela here in the second chapter. Srila Kaviraj Goswami has confirmed that the opinion of Swarup Damodara is authoritative in the matter of devotional service. over and above this are the notes of Swarup Damodara memorized by Raghunath Das Goswami, who also helped in the compilation of the Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. After the disappearance of Swarup Damodara Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami went to Vrindavana. At that time, the author Srila Kaviraj Goswami met Raghunath Das Goswami, by whose mercy he also could memorize all the notes. In this way, the author was able to complete this transcendental literature, Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. So this is chapter 2, the ecstatic manifestations of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is Madhya Lila, chapter 2. Now, a good portion of this discusses about the ecstatic symptoms of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually demonstrating Mahabhava of Srimati Radharani, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Radha, Srimati Radharani and Krishna combined. So the details of that we will go through when we go to Antya Leela. I'll be touching on some of the verses today. We'll start today, we'll be able to finish tomorrow. But these verses are very important, because this series of verses is going to tell us the activities of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Actually, second chapter is one of the smallest ones you will come across. There are only about like 95 verses. So I'll start reading from 77. The last one third portion of this chapter, it discusses about the activities of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which is very, very exemplary for all practicing sadhakas. And secondly, you will also see the benefit which we get by reading Chaitanya Charitamrita, hearing Chaitanya Charitamrita, even if we don't understand it fully. So text 77. So this is this series of verses discuss about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's activities. This is Madhya Lila, chapter 2, text 77. He also passed his time, which is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, also passed his time reading the books and singing the songs of Chandidasa and Vidyapati. Chandidasa has a famous pastime. As his name suggests, he is a worshipper of Chandidevi, which is Mother Parvati. If you read Krishna book, when Krishna actually speaks to Yogamaya, you appear and you'll be called by different names. If you read the series of names, you will see Chandidevi there. So he is a worshipper of Chandi. However, his brother is a Vaishnava. His brother tries to preach to him, asking him to worship Vishnu, telling Vishnu is the Supreme Lord, Krishna is the Supreme Lord, worship. But in vain. So then one day what happens, Chandidasa, he wants to perform his puja, he searches everywhere, couldn't find flowers. Then he picks up a tray of flowers which he finds in his home, and he offers to Mother Kali, to Chandidevi. But much to his surprise, as soon as he offers the first flower, from the deity, Chandidevi herself came out. And deity itself started to move. And he could see Chandidevi face to face, and he feels so blissed. Wow, finally my bhakti to Mother Kali is bearing fruit. But then he asks Chandidevi, what pleased you more today? Then Chandidevi says, you know, my dear bhakta, every day you used to offer boga flower, today what you offer is Mahavishnu, Mahaprasad of Vishnu. So that flower which is offered to the lotus feet of Vishnu, that is very, very dear to me. The plate of flowers which you found in your home, because you couldn't find anywhere, they are all the flowers that were already offered to Vishnu by your brother. You know, be thankful to your brother. So then she tells him, you go and worship Krishna. So because she becomes the guru of Chandidas, that's how he actually accepts Mother Parvati or Chandidevi as his guru. And from that point, he calls himself Chandidas. And then he writes beautiful poems glorifying about the pastimes of Krishna. It is so authorized that even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself used to recite and relish. So that is Chandidas. And Chandidas is also, this pastime is also telling us, proving us, just like so many pastimes, like Jadabharat pastime, you know, Dhruva Maharaj getting boon from Kuvera, Shiva associating with Sanatana Goswami, for example, the Brahmanas who worshipped Shiva, and they get the boon that may they become the students of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that whenever we approach any demigod, asking them to benefit us, asking them to benedict us with Krishna Bhakti, they feel very, very pleased and they give us Krishna Bhakti straight away. So here also we can see, he also passed his time, again verse 77, he also passed his time reading the books and singing the songs of Chandidasa and Vidyapati. Vidyapati is also one of the great Vaishnava poets. And listening to the quotations from the Jagannatha Vallabha Nadaka, Krishna Karnamrita and Gita Govinda. Thus, in the association of Swarup Damodara and Raya Ramananda. Raya means, Prabhupada says, somebody who is very, very rich. Raya Ramananda, he was governor of Madras actually during the time. Thus, in the association of Swarup Damodara and Raya Ramananda, Ramananda is also Arjuna, Supreme Lord's eternal friend, Arjuna and Vishakasaki combined appearance. Raya Ramananda, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu passed his days and nights chanting and hearing with great pleasure. I'll finish with this verse. This is verse 78. Among his associates, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu enjoyed paternal loving affection from Paramananda Puri, friendly affection with Ramananda Roy, unalloyed service from Govinda, who was his personal secretary or servant, and others, and humors of conjugal love with Gadadhar, which is Gadadhar Pandit, Jagadananda Pandit, and Swarup Damodara. They're all gopis actually. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu enjoyed all these four mellows, which is Vatsalya, Sakya, Dasya, and Madhurya. Vatsalya he enjoyed with Paramananda Puri, Dasya he enjoyed with Govinda, Madhurya with Gadadhar, Jagadananda Pandit, and Swarup Damodara, and Sakya with Ramananda Roy, which is Arjuna and Vishakha together. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, as Rasaraj Krishna, he enjoyed all these four mellows, and thus he remained obliged to his devotees. So I'll quickly finish the purport. Paramananda Puri is said to have been Uddhava. So Paramananda Puri is Uddhava in Vrindavan. His affections with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu were on the platform of paternal love. This was because Paramananda Puri happened to be the god brother of the spiritual master of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Who is the spiritual master of his of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Ishwara Puri. So Paramananda Puri is also disciple of Madhavendra Puri along with Ishwara Puri. Similarly, Ramananda Roy, who is considered an incarnation of Arjuna and by some an incarnation of Vishakha Devi, enjoyed unalloyed fraternal love with the Lord. Unalloyed personal service was enjoyed by Govinda and others in the presence of his most confidential devotees like Gadadhar Pandit, Jagadananda Pandit, and Swarup Damodara. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu enjoyed the ecstatic conditions of Srimati Radharani in her conjugal relationship with Krishna. Absorbed in these four transcendental mellows, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu resided in Jagannath Puri, feeling very much obliged to his devotees. So when it comes to serving the Lord, we can see each of these different devotees, they are just focused on giving pleasure to the Lord. You know, sometimes we may think enjoyment means you can have with only people in our own age group, because you don't know how to have enjoyment with, like, you know, somebody who is like older, younger, and everyone. Because at different phases in life, we feel comfortable with a certain age group. Now, when you are very, very small, at that time, we prefer to be around elders. Little grown up, you want to be in your own, like, you know, age group, like that. But Supreme Lord, He is Akila Rasamrita Murti. He can enjoy all the rasas at all the time with everyone simultaneously. So here Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is demonstrating. We may think Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas. No, he is still enjoying all these different rasas with each one of these different devotees. And different devotees, one example is given is Paramananda Puri, who is Uddhava. In Krishna Leela, he is friend. But here, simply to give that affection, that transcendental mellow to the Supreme Lord, he doesn't mind. Narada Muni, Naishtik Brahmachari, here he is coming as a grahastha, simply to give pleasure to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. For that 1 year, he wanted to make sure Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pleasure goes unhindered before he takes his sannyas. So Narada Muni doesn't mind, you know, changing the ashram altogether. So you will find the focus of the devotees is simply to give pleasure to the Lord, nothing else. So may that be our constant meditation. How can I increase the pleasure of Sri Sri Radha Gopinath? How can we increase the opulence of Sri Sri Radha Gopinath. Prabhupada says the real opulence of Krishna is his devotees only. So we need to expand this movement, share this message, and then that way we can keep on increasing the opulence of the Supreme Lord. Okay, we'll finish there. Tomorrow we'll go through the rest of chapter 2 and then start from chapter 3. So chapter 2 is still the concluding portion of Antyalila, and then technically we'll start Madhyalila from tomorrow, which is from chapter 3. Jagadguru Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Shri Shri Radha Gopinath Bhagwan ki jai. Shri Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Maharani ki jai. Shri Shri Gaur Anitai ki jai. Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita ki jai. Samaved Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki.